All right, guys, it's extremely cold outside, and so I decided to bring my project inside and do some wet sanding and buffing. Doing it in here in my storage room basement, sharing it with my cat. My wife's cat. I can't stand cats myself. But I'm going to do some wet sanding and buffing on the tank and the fender and the other parts that I painted, just to make them look a little bit better. I think the paint came out pretty good, but I got the time, got the, you know, stuff to do it, so I'm gonna cut it and wet sand it, buff it with a bunch of different compounds, and see what we can get this paint to look like. Alright, first thing I'm gonna do is do a little wet sanding on it with some 2000 grit sandpaper. So, get my pads out of the way here. So I'm just going to use some 2000 grit and lightly wet sand this. I've never used this Duplicolor system that I use, so I don't know how well the clear will hold up. So I don't want to hit it real hard. I'm just going to hit it with some light wet sanding and just see if we can knock out some of the roughness and just make this pretty smooth. So not putting much pressure on it, just kind of letting the sandpaper and the water do the work. And I'm trying to really watch the edges. I don't want to go through anywhere. I'm just going to continue this process through the whole tank, so I'm not going to record the whole thing. I'll come back when I start doing the buffing on it. All right, like I said, hope you can see okay in here. Lighting's not the best, but here's what I like to do when I'm buffing out paint like this. I like to use, first, start off with the Chemical Guys 32, then go to 36, and then go to 38. And then I like this Grottos, I think is how it's pronounced, Fast Correcting Cream, and then finish it off with Perfecting Cream. And these are the five compounds that I like to use when I'm buffing something out like this. I know I skip 32 to 36 to 38, but that's just the way I like to do it. So, I'll probably use all these. I've got this wet sanded down and knocked some of the orange peel out of it. So we'll hit it with the three compounds. I'm going to start with this piece and then just work my way through all four pieces, and we'll see how it goes. So I went over all the pieces with the first compound. I can already see that it's making this a lot smoother. So I'm going to go keep working through on all the compounds. We'll come back on the last one. We'll see how it looks. And by the way, I'm using a Torx X Orbital Polisher. I like this polisher. I got it from Chemical Guys, and it does a really good job and helps you not to be able to burn a hole in the paint or the clear, and it works really well. I really like it. It has adjustable. I usually do on the first phase. I don't go pass like three on the first part of the polishing because the number 32 is so gritty. I don't want it to burn it. I just want it to polish it. And so I'm going to do the same through the next few compounds. And as I go through on the compounds, I up the speed of the buffer as well. So it's just something you have to work with and whatever works best for you. But this is definitely taking a lot of the orange peel out of this clear. And it's right now it's real flat, but it will get real shiny, hopefully, by the time we get to the end. So I'm going to just jump. We'll just jump ahead to the last compound on the next part of the video or time lapse, and we'll go from there. All right, guys, here's the tank finished. I went through all the different compounds. I hope this camera's bringing out how nice this looks. I might have to take it out in the sun and show you, but this tank came out looking amazing. And, you know, it's just a little bit of work, a little bit of polishing. You know, you don't have to put a lot of pressure on it. Let the polisher do the work. And it looks phenomenal. So let me take it outside, get it in some sunlight, and let you see it. Well, we don't have much sunlight, but you can see it outside how shiny and smooth this is. This is just cheap Duplicolor paint in clear, and it did a phenomenal job. I'm going to work on the rest of the parts that I have out, and you know, maybe a day when we have a little bit more sunlight out here, it'll look a little bit better. But came out phenomenal. I'm very happy with the tank, and hope you can see what you can do for a little bit of money and a little bit of time. So thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe. We have more to come on this bike.